Dear traders, after you install your MetaTrader platform and you are logged into your account, you have the connection to the server of the broker, you see the prices moving, you are pretty much ready to trade. So in this lecture, I will go briefly over the MetaTrader platform. So if you are using it for the first time, you will feel comfortable for the rest of the course and you can follow along. Now, when I have installed the platform in the previous lecture, I had by default four charts, one for euro dollar, dollar Swiss, pound dollar, dollar yen. And most of the brokers will give you some default layout, but you can change pretty much all of that. So for example, if I want to tile the windows, I can right click and go to tile windows, or that will be alt plus R combination on your keyboard, and you see the four windows are displayed equally on the screen. And I can change any of these currency pairs as well simply by drag and drop the currency pair I want to trade. So for example, if I want to trade dollar Canadian instead of euro dollar, I can just drag and drop it over the euro dollar, and you will see I have now the dollar Canadian. So on the left side we have the market watch, where we see all the trading assets, and if you don't see all of them, what you can do is simply right click over it and go to show all. This will display all the assets that the broker provides, and if I scroll down you will see that I have currency pairs, commodities, indexes, and here are the cryptocurrencies: Bitcoin, Dash, Ethereum, Litecoin. And in the market watch we have two prices. One is the bid price and then we have the ask price. Now the bid price is cheaper than the ask price. If you look at the Bitcoin at the moment, it is 10,709.51 as a bid price, and it is 10,719.20 something with the ask price, or $10 more. Why is that? Because this is the spread. If I right click again and I go to spread, a third column will appear and it will show the spread. For the moment, it is fixed with Pepperstone for the Bitcoin at $10. You can see the Ethereum is about $2 and the Litecoin about $3, Dash is about $3 as well. So something important to know about the bid and the ask price is that we buy the asset at the ask price, which is the more expensive price, and we sell at the bid price, which is the cheaper price. Now if I drag and drop the Bitcoin over the chart, you will see that my buy price is the more expensive one, 10,727, and the sell is 10,717. Or if I buy one Bitcoin now, I will buy it at the more expensive price, which is the ask price, and if I want to close the position, I will be closing it on the bid price, and I will pay this difference of $10 to the broker, which is called the spread. And this is one of the ways that the brokers benefit from our trading. Okay, it's just like the exchange bureau, the bank. When you go to exchange currencies, there is always difference between the bid and the ask price, or the sell and the buy price. So it is very, very important to look for the brokers that have small spread, because obviously if you have huge spread, this will minimize your profits. And in most of my courses, I include expert advisors, and sometimes some students report profits, others report losses with the very same expert advisors for the same period of time. And this is because they use different brokers, and some have like really huge spreads, especially for the Bitcoin. All right, so trading with small spread is vital, and always look for the brokers that have smaller spread. Now below the market watch we have the navigator, where we see our accounts. If you have a live account here, it will be displayed, or another demo account. We have the indicators, which I will show a little bit later. And below we have the expert advisors, where we can place the expert advisors, and I will show you how to do that a little bit later in the course. And we have the scripts, which are very useful, especially when we create expert advisors, export historical data from the broker, and many other things. So all of these windows are customizable. For example, I can decrease the size of the navigator. Usually I keep it that way just to see the expert advisors that I have. I can change as well the place, so I can drag it above the market watch. But usually I keep it the way it is, the way it comes after the installation, and I just customize the chart windows. Below we have the terminal, where we will see the open trades, the closed trades, the result. We will see the account history once we have the expert advisors trading. And on the top we have different drawing tools like horizontal lines, vertical lines. We have the trend line, which you can use if you have such a strategy. I show many strategies in my courses using trend lines, and especially counter trend lines. And we have the different time frames. So for example, with the Bitcoin, I'm at H4 chart right now. I can change it to M1 or to M5 and M50. So these are the available time frames. And we have the daily chart, weekly and monthly. So what that means for the beginners, if I am on M15 chart, it means that one candlestick is 15 minutes of a time. Okay, now it is 9:23:20, and when it is 9:30 or 9:30, we will see a new candlestick opening. Okay, so one candle represents 15 minutes. If I switch to hourly chart, one candle will represent 1 hour. So when we have the full hour complete and the new one starts, a new candlestick will open. On the top, we have as well a different chart types. So we have candlesticks, we have the bar chart, which is very similar to the candlestick, but with the candlesticks, we have more visual representation of the price. And we have as well the line chart, which is just a line connecting the closings of these candlesticks. In this case, by default, when I install the platform, I have white candlesticks if it's a negative bar, so the price opened at the price of 10,748.38 and it closed at 10,697.26. Okay, it opened here, it closed here, and it's a negative bar. And the next one, the one we have until the moment, it's positive. You can see that it opened at 10,695 and still it didn't close. So we'll see how this bar will close at the end of the hour. So what I will do now, I will just remove the other charts. I will close the pound dollar, dollar yen, and dollar Swiss. I will leave just the Bitcoin. And in the next lecture, I will show you what is the setup for the first strategy. And along the course, I will show you more about the MetaTrader platform, how we put indicators, how we change the chart. And until the end of the course, you will feel comfortable using the MetaTrader platform. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next lecture.